Give a round of applause for Kleinhan. We are honored to be here this evening. And in the spirit of Hispanic Heritage Month, we embrace our theme, Hispanics, a legacy of history, a present of action, and a future of success. With that, I'd like to welcome once again each and every one of you. And at this time, I'd like to call Dan Hart to the podium. And while he's coming up, I'd like to share with you a few words. Back in 2009, I was a member of the Erie County Cultural Resource Board. For the County of Erie, I was appointed to that commission by then County Executive Chris Collins. I didn't know much about arts and culture. And of that, and the ideas of that, after hearing over 50 plus arts and cultural organizations here in Western New York, the idea of forming the Hispanic Heritage Council came to be. And with that, I would like to thank our executive board of directors. If they're in the audience, I'd like for them to stand up at this time. This is a hard working group of individuals with full-time jobs, and some of them do not have the luxury of some of us that are retired, but they all have the same passion and the same vision for community. Then, 2009, I met you, and we exchanged a few words while I was interviewing you back then. And this was at the Buffalo Convention Center, where many of the arts and cultural groups came to present their strategic plans and their proposals on how they're going to expand the arts and culture and theater groups in our area. And after we got through with the discussion, with the interview, I pulled Dan aside and said, Dan, we gotta do something for the surrounding community of Kleinhan Music Hall, which is in the heart of the Hispanic community. And let me tell you, since then, there has been an unwavering commitment by Dan Hart, the administration of Kleinhan Music Hall, the Buffalo Philharmonic, in embracing and promoting Hispanic heritage here in Western New York. If we go back to the history books, and I like a lot of history, Dan brought Jose Feliciano with his administration to our area. Let's give a round of applause for him. He followed with that with Rita Moreno with the collaboration with the Hispanic Women's League, Hispanos Unidos de Buffalo, and our organization. He brought Rita Moreno. And after that, we had a Hispanic Heritage Month main event with Johnny Olivo and his Bomba y Plena Orchestra. I say this from the bottom of my heart, and I know that each and every one of our board of directors of our council feel the same, because we've had much dialogue around the table at our meetings about recognizing this individual, but not only recognizing him, but recognizing the commitment that he has, not only to the arts and culture here in Western New York, but to our community. Dan, as a token of appreciation, we want to present you just a little something.
The Salsa in Motion, Casimiro Rodriguez Jr.
Thank you.
too much of your time, Casimiro. We had the pleasure of seeing Jason Robinson. He's a Buffalo native, has been instructing salsa for 15 years. While in the United States Air Force, Jason held classes in locations such as Iceland, Germany, and Saudi Arabia. That's a big deal. Amazing. Thank you, Jason. We would also like to thank Mr. Stefan Sanders of the BTO, who's doing an amazing job tonight as well. So, without further ado, I'd like to welcome one more time Grammy Award winner and former Spanish Harlem Orchestra lead singer Willy Torres and Casimiro Rodriguez Jr. with Salsa in Motion.